Hello and welcome to Kemper Bushcraft. Yeah, it's a big day today. I launched my little canoe here in Limfjorden near a place called Lovns Bredning. I can't translate it to Danish, but it's a wonderful area here. It's not a sea and it's not a lake. It's an insel, I think it's called. And we've got a lot of water here around where I live, so I have plenty of opportunity to test my canoe. And as you saw, I have it on my car and the way I pulled it down and put it in the water. So, and the reason why I have the opportunity to buy a canoe is because there's a very friendly company called Kayak Freaks that is located down in Jutland, about 100 kilometers from where I live, and they agreed to give me a canoe with a good discount so I can make some footage of that, and perhaps they could use that in their commercial too. I'm very grateful that they have agreed to this agreement with me, so I have the opportunity to come out here and make some kind of other videos that I hope you like too. It's a wonderful day today. You can see the sun is shining and there's no wind at all. And the fjord is quiet and very easy to paddle on. So, and I made a little lunch here, a little burger. It was very delicious. And in a moment I'm going to make my coffee. But when I look back, it's almost 1.5 years since I announced on my YouTube channel that I'm going to buy a canoe and sometime. And now, 1.5 years later, I actually succeeded in that. I had some problems with the first canoe that I ordered. They said that it was because of the coronavirus that they hadn't time to make them. So I waited and waited for a month and it didn't turn up. So I decided to contact another dealer, Kayak Freaks, and again they offered me a deal for that, so I'm very grateful. And now finally I've got it, and I really enjoy paddling here in this wonderful environment. So, and I actually forgot my my Zippo lighter up in the car, so I had to make a fire before I could light my pipe. But then again, it's old school, and if you can't light your fire without a lighter, you're not bushcrafting, are you? No. So, skål to all of you, and my, I think it's called a maiden voyage with my new little Viking boat. It's very exciting, and well, it's been a wonderful day. I really enjoy being out here. And beside these fjords I can sail in, I also have some rivers, small rivers that I can sail in, and I'm looking forward to that too, and perhaps make an overnighter somewhere. Yeah. Now I'm going to make my coffee and enjoy the rest of the afternoon here, just looking out on the water and seeing my canoe down there. Lying down and just looking so beautiful. I'm so happy for that. Yeah, and I almost forgot to tell you what the brand this canoe is.
It's called Silver Birch, British made canoe. So it is made in Britain, and I'm told that it is a really good quality. And this model is the Firefly 14. So I think it's 14 foot long, and it weighs about 27 kilos. So I can handle it by myself most of the time, and well, I think it's a cool canoe. I love it, and I'm sailing really good in it. So,
well, folks, this is all for now. I hope you enjoy my little video, my new type of video I make. Also, beside, I'm going out to the forest still, and of course my Kimber camp. But this is a new addition to my channel and the content you can expect to have in the future, and hope you like that. It's been a wonderful day, and as you can hear, the birds are singing, and the weather is perfect for this. I'm just a lucky man. Well, thank you again for watching Kimber Bushcraft. I really appreciate that, and I'm soon reaching the 50,000 subscribers. It's amazing. I can understand that, and of course there'll be a giveaway there. Perhaps I'll do it after I come home from my vacation to Norway, I don't know, or before, it depends on some things. But again, thank you for supporting me and for all your kind comments. Hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye, take care. Yeah, and last but not least, my Polish Slavu. I got a lot of response again for my trying to make it more waterproof in my latest video, and many of you subscribers have asked me or told me that I actually had turned that Slavu inside out, that what I had inside with the flaps are going to be outside, and I don't agree with that. Two reasons. First of all, I have a video that tells you it's a Polish man that show how you're going to set this Slavu up, and he agreed with me that it shall be on the inside that the flaps are. I'll put a link below in my video description so you can watch that video. But the main reason why I choose to put it up like that is, this is how I put it up, and these are for the hands, the arms for the soldier. He can put his arms out here, and this is what I have on the outside. If I choose to make it, as some of you have suggested, put it inside, then this will be outside, and as you can see here, there's no protection from the rain. If the rain comes down here, it will go into the Slavu. So this is not an option. This is not protected from the rain. So this is an important issue when you're putting up your Slavu. These ones have to be inside. These are going to be sealed from water. So that's the reason why I started using this and that way, and I think it's the right way. So again, thank you for all your comments. I'm very grateful that so many of you are interested and involved in what I'm doing on my YouTube channel. Thank you very much. So I hope this will solve any issues about how this LAVO is going to be set up, and I hope you agree with me.